Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have a really awesome Cricut tutorial. This time we are showing you how to make your very own custom photo puzzle. All right guys, so here we are in Cricut Design Space, and of course we're just starting with a blank canvas, nothing over the top, nothing special about it. And we're going to go ahead and go to upload. And there are going to be two items that we bring in. The first item is going to be our photo. Now, this is just a cute, well, I mean, I think it's cute. Of course, I think it's cute. It's my kid. But it's just a cute little photo. I snapped it at the ballpark. Of course, she absolutely loves when she has blue lips. So we got a little kissy face. And I'm going to choose this as a print then cut image. So let's go ahead and upload that, and then we're going to go back in and we're going to upload our jigsaw puzzle. Now, if you haven't already, make sure that you extract that, okay? You have to, 9 times out of 10, when you download a purchase or a free SVG file, you're going to go ahead and extract that. It keeps it a smaller file size. That way it's easier to upload and download from the website. So it'll take just a minute. And once it's extracted, then it'll be available for you to import into Cricut Design Space. We'll just have to choose which one, because this one was a bundle of different puzzle designs, okay? So after extracting, it'll pop up in a brand new folder right here. And I personally am going to use the heart puzzle. Now you have a couple to choose from, so let's just take a look. If we go to the PNG and click open, this is the hearts puzzle number 4. Okay, cute, but not what I'm looking for. And this is another hearts puzzle. And I'm just right clicking on the design, guys. That's the one I want. Okay, so this one is 4 hearts puzzle 1-01. So I want to find that coordinating SVG. I bet it's going to be this one right above it. So let's go ahead and double click. There we go. And I'm going to hit upload. Now I'm going to select both of these and choose insert images, and it should insert both of them into my blank canvas. And they come over quite nicely, if I do say so myself. If you're worried about size, because I have zoomed out, this is at 25%. But if you're worried about size, you can definitely make them smaller. Or if your image just comes in really big, you can zoom out or make it smaller. And what we want to do is I'm going to change this from basic cut to score. All right, the reason I'm going to do that is it's going to make it transparent. And then when I bring my image over, I can make it the right size. Okay. So if I zoom back in, you can see, and I'm not gonna lie, I wish that the picture was a little wider, because then I could actually get a little bit more of her face in there, but I still think it's going to be a really cute puzzle, and it's not like I'm not gonna know whose face it is, right? All right, so just to make it exact, the size of this, let's do 12 inches, and then I can click the photo and do 12 inches. And now I can align center horizontally. All right, so that's pretty good. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a shape. Now this isn't absolutely necessary. This will depend on the type of, or rather the size of picture you have. But I'm gonna make this just a little larger. And I'm gonna lay it over. I'm gonna select it with my photo. I just held down my control key, my shift key, or you can come over here and make sure they're both selected. And I'm gonna choose slice, because I don't actually need to print that entire photo. So I can delete the parts that I don't need. I can delete that rectangle that I don't need. Let's see, and send that to back. All right. So now I'm not wasting unnecessary ink. Okay. I can even make this just a tad larger, even though I know we just sized it to 12 inches, but all right. Center horizontally. Now what we want to do is I want to go ahead and attach those together. because I want this to print and cut exactly where it's at. Okay, so now we need to think about a size. Now there is a maximum print and cut size for Cricut Design Space. There is technically a way to get around that, but not with how we're setting up this project, okay? That gets into a little bit more of a, like an intermediate project. So we're not gonna mess with that right now. What I wanna do is I need to take my smallest portion here. I need to make it within the print and cut guidelines, which is 6.75. So then when I click over to make it, there we go. All right, is that making sense? All right, so let's hit cancel. Let's go back. And actually, let's unattach for just a moment. And we need to change this back from score to basic. And we need to send to back. And now we can select those and attach again. And go back to make it. Okay, so this is what's going to print. Now, what I'm going to do, and you'll see this more hands-on in just a minute, but just to give you a heads up in case you're wondering what I'm doing here, I'm going to print this on sticker paper, and then I'm going to apply the sticker paper to a sheet of chipboard, and that is going to be the base for my puzzle, okay? If you do not have sticker paper, you can also use printable vinyl. That's okay. Sometimes printable vinyl and sticker paper, it depends on how often you're going to handle this, that you may want to also apply, you know, something to seal it on there, or make sure that you use a waterproof sticker paper, something that's going to seal the ink in, just because sometimes the oil from your hands can wear the ink off. But for me, I'm just going to use regular sticker paper. It is a glossy sticker paper, but I'm going to use regular sticker paper. I'm going to apply it to my chipboard, and then that's what I'm going to cut on my software, okay? So for now, I'm going to hit continue, and I'm going to go to send to printer, and I am going to let it print the bleed, okay? So I'm just going to select the printer I want to use. Let's see, where is my inkjet? There we go. And if you want, if it's easier for you, you can use the system dialog box. Like if you need to change the type of material you're printing on or anything like that, I'm just going to go ahead and hit print and let that print over to my printer. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the software portion, and I'm going to show you how I apply this to the chipboard, okay? All right, guys, so this is what I have. This is my picture printed on my sticker paper, and this is my chipboard. Now, I do have chipboard that is the same size. That's, I'm not going to say like that's super important, but it's really convenient for what I'm going to do, because I'm going to remove the backing off the bottom part of this, and it's going to help me adhere the sticker paper to my chipboard. All right, you'll see what I mean in just a second. So I'm using just a craft knife to try to get this started, because sometimes it can be a little stubborn getting the backing off of, you know, sticker paper like this. Especially the, it makes that squeaking sound, right? Okay, the glossy paper does. So what I want to do is just peel this back. And now I can leave that folded, but really, guys, it's easier if I just go ahead and cut part of it off. Now what I'm going to do is I can line this up on the top and just smooth it down. All right, let me grab my squeegee. These felt covered squeegee tips are really, really useful for this kind of thing. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fold this back over, pull the backing back up, and then I'm just gonna smooth down my sticker paper. This is gonna help me not to get bubbles, okay? It's also important, guys, you know, I'm using this, I used an inkjet printer. It's very important to make sure that your ink is dry before you do this. So no bubbles, all right? That worked out really, really good. I'm gonna grab, now this is a pretty beat up mat, okay? That's intentional because I'm gonna be using my knife blade, and I don't wanna have to worry about if it cuts too deep that it's gonna ruin a new mat, okay? Now, with that being said, because it is beat up, I'm going to tape the sides just to make sure it stays in place, all right? I'm not saying this is necessary, especially if your mat is really sticky, but I know sometimes these thicker materials, they don't like to stay in place, so we are going to play it safe. All right, so I'm gonna load this into my Cricut Maker. And guys, I already have, I'm using my knife blade, okay? So this is my knife blade. And when you insert it, you just want to make sure that your gears on your blade line up with the gears inside, and then close it. But remember, if you have to force it, that means something's wrong, okay? So don't feel like you have to force it in there. So let's go back over to the software, and I will show you about setting this up to print and the settings that we're going to use. All right, so I have already printed. You guys saw that. We've loaded it in the machine. I am going to select on my software that I'm using on my Cricut Maker, and it's going to go through the connection process. Should just take a minute. Okay, now I'm going to select I have already printed, and then this is where I'm going to select my chipboard. Now it gives me an option, chipboard, heavy chipboard, light chipboard. I am going to choose the heavy chipboard, and that is not only because it is a fairly heavy chipboard, but I also have the sticker paper to think about. So the regular chipboard setting probably will not cut all the way through because we've added the thickness of the sticker paper. So I'm just gonna hit done. And I'm not gonna calibrate my blade, but if you guys want to, that's completely fine. And it's gonna tell me it's gonna be a long time, so that's okay. I'm glad it tells me that, so I know, you know, not to hold my breath and stand there and try to watch it, but I'm gonna head on over there and start the cutting process. All right, guys, so I'm actually happy to report that it did not take all the passes. It originally said that it would take 24 passes and that it would take 3 hours to cut. So I was a little anxious about that, but I've been checking in on it every time one of the passes ends. And I'll say we made it all the way to pass number 10. And now we have a finished puzzle. So I don't know if you can see or not, there were a few double cuts. You can see with some of the chipboard that's coming up, that's completely normal. You can just completely brush those off. I'm gonna tap them off of my thing here. So we may have to do just a little bit of cleanup there. But guys, you can see I got a very good cut on all of my puzzle pieces. They're interlocking together like they're supposed to. And because I called it quits early, it didn't damage my mat. So what I'm going to do is go around, see here's some of the, we'll just call it debris. I'm gonna go around with my diamond tip reamer. That's what this is. You can also use probably a piece of sandpaper, but I'm just going to go around and those spots that have scragglers, I'm just going to file them off. It should be real, real simple. And guys, there we go. That is our cute little puzzle. Now, of course, when it's time to package it up, you can find a box and leave it like this, or you can simply break it up into little pieces, find a little bag or a little box to put it in. And that's half the fun, is letting your recipient or you know, whatever you're gonna do with this, I like to give them as a gift, so I assume everybody wants to give it as a gift, but let them figure out all the pieces that go together, and then it'll be a nice surprise once they do, because they will be able to see the finished picture. Okay guys, so what did you think about setting up our custom puzzle? Now, you know, the software part was really easy, the cutting part was really easy, because Cricut does all the hard parts for us, right? So as long as you keep something on hand to clean up the edges, like sandpaper, or you know, that diamond tip reamer that I love, and you do have to have the knife blade. So, you know, if you haven't already made that purchase, we have not only this project, but another really awesome project to show you how to use your knife blade. So definitely a worthy cause. But guys, if you have any questions or comments, definitely make sure you leave that down below. As you know, I do love hearing from you guys, and I always do my best to answer the questions that you have. And in return, if you don't mind, if you'll just do a quick subscribe, share with a crafty friend. I just really love all the support that you show for us here and to help us keep bringing you these videos in the future. So guys, I'm gonna wrap it up for today, but thanks again for stopping by, and we'll see you again next time.